All right, let's read. This story touched my heart this morning when I was hearing about Ruth 1.
Taba ye ngwa tlo pele o seng mola go Ruth 1
verse 6 to 11. I'm going to share the word, but it will be very short. Then 11. She arose with her daughters-in-law that she might return from the country of Moab. For she had heard in the country of Moab how that Jehovah had visited his people in giving them bread. And she went forth out of the place where she was, and her two daughters-in-law with her. And they went on their way to return unto the land of Judah. Verse 8, and Naomi said unto her two daughters-in-law, return each of you of her mother's house. Jehovah deal kindly with you, as he have dealt with the dead and with me. Jehovah grant you that he may find rest, each of you in the house of her husband. Then she kissed them, and they lifted up their voice and wept. And they said unto her, nay, but we will return with thee unto thy people. Can you see that verse there?
Amen.
Let's pray. Father, thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I want us to speak about testing of your faith. Testing of your faith. Not long I found that always when we speak words, we are going to be checked if we are meaning them. I will give you an example. The moment when you wet and the graph goes down and you find that there is poverty now, no food, nothing. Know that is a test of marriage. But it's also testing the words you have spoken. Test of faith is a test of the words you have spoken. If you say you are here forever, challenges will rise to test you if you mean the business. Don't ever think there will be no challenges. They are there so that God will honor your ways. Test of faith. Change your determination. Your determination is the quality of strength that is needed in you when there is no way of moving forward and you find yourself moving forward. When God check your determination, there have to be winds that will blow. Things that are not pleasing will come upon your life so that you prove that you mean business when you say
trust.
This happens to Orpah and
Ruth.
They moved out and say they are going out with
Naomi.
It's after all their husbands died. But if you can see where we have read now, this was the beginning of test of their faith. The first one was prayer. What Naomi did was, I have accepted. But now, let me bless you, you go back. But the Bible says, all of them could not say amen to that prayer. What they did was, Naomi, we are following you to
Judah.
And then if you read going down.
Jano auka ibala kaya kabutzanya na utiwali yon.
From verse 11 now.
Utuwa verse 11 eh jano.
You realize that the test went further.
Utalimlemo ulekula kula wila chela pele.
Naomi said.
Are Naomi.
Even if you try to follow me.
Leka 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 unchalam rao batwesh.
Look at myself.
Ageng lintibeleleng.
Even if I can have a child.
Leka enka trikina limu ruana juale.
Will you wait for that child?
Leto muemela na mshimanuo.
There is no other way.
Awona tsila.
That you can have hope with me.
Ya uri kulu fele mo naika sato ba onan.
Turn back my daughters.
Welang mora oba ready baka.
And the Bible says.
Bible iri.
Truly when they were checked.
Janong haba lekulu abo sesiba.
Opa when she looked at Naomi.
Opera lebelela Naomi.
She saw hopeless.
Abona kulu fele isiyo.
Because that's where your faith.
Kauri kimo utu mudumela gaga.
Is tested.
Ule kuluanting.
Your faith is tested where there's no hope. The moment when there's nothing that can come to help you. Know that there's still God who can answer. I don't know if you're hearing that. They were tested there. When Opa looked at
Naomi.
She said, really? This lady, she's finished. But when Ruth looked at Naomi, she said, I'm not going anywhere. Your God is my God. Where you will sleep, I will sleep. Where you will die, I will die. And the Bible says, she clinged in
Naomi.
In other words, she proved Naomi that there is no any other way from her that can discourage her. Listen to this. On the test of your faith, if you are tested, you win. There will be another greater test. If truly God wants to do something, there will be another great challenge. Most of the time, we think that when we face trouble, and we pray over it, it's
and
over. There can still be another challenge, which is bigger. Therefore, you cannot be determined by any blessing you see, but by clinging unto the Lord. That's where God can take you from. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen to this. Most of the time when God tests our determination, is when we have hope. But think about when there's no hopeless. When our eyes are depicting something that there is nothing that can rise again. But still we hold on. I can tell you by that you are provoking God to do something. There are some people here. They've been in charis. They had many stories that were supposed to remove them from charis. But they are still here. They are facing challenges. And nothing is moving. But this word belongs to you. God has checked your determination. And that determination will pay off. You are about to receive things that you have never received by anyone in your family because of your determination. I have read Jesus preaching about determination in the book of Luke 18 verse 3. When he was speaking about a widow, and this widow, there was no one who can stand for her. And the Bible says, she was in the city, but she went to a lawyer and said, please revenge for me. And the lawyer said, hey, I'm already tired, I'm asleep. I have my own engagements. But she never got tired. Because if you know that your faith, when it's tested, it also need your persistence. If you carry on pushing, and something will happen. So Jesus was saying, determination brought solution. Because she carried on. When she was chased back, she came back again and knocked again. Please fight for me. Please fight for me. And until she got solution. Can I tell you this? Jesus said, what about those who cry day and night? Their determination of expecting the results to come to them from the Father. How much more of them who are crying day and night, our Father will answer them speedily. I don't know if you're hearing that. Tell someone, my friend, you have been crying, but God this time, He will never leave you. He will answer you. Your determination was showing you believe in Him. Was showing that you trust Him. There was a time whereby some Christians I was with, they were checked if they will follow me forever. And they were not supporting. By that time, I was still having a church there. And later they said, God is not blessing them because He's not blessing me. He must start to bless me. I knew they fail in their test. Can I tell you this? When you fail, when your faith fails, you begin to blame other people. You point other people. This is not the time of looking at others on the bad eye. This is the time of rising up and still believe that God can do it. And that God will do it. I don't know if you are hearing me. Shake somebody and say, hey, I don't see anything, but I still believe. I know tough times, but I still believe. I know what I face, but I believe this week is going to be the last week. Last week, this Sunday is the last Sunday of talking about the past challenge. I was determined to move forward, and I will move forward whether the devil likes it or not. I will move forward whether the devil stops me or not. I'm moving forward. If you believe, shout hallelujah. If you read Numbers
14,
verse 1 to 10.
14, 1 to 10.
You see Joshua and Caleb.
Joshua, Sulu, Caleb.
They were part of 10 spies.
But
when we add them, they were
12.
And the Bible says, they went to spy the land. And they found they were children of Anak. They were giants in Canaan. And when they come back, everybody was afraid. But these guys, these two people, they say it's God who made us to reach it. It's God who brought us
here.
And he's the one who spoke that Canaan belong to us. Though we saw the giants, we can take over. Let's go at once. And the Bible says, the people heard them. And they wanted to stone them because they were a stumbling block. They realized that if truly these people are speaking, if they go there, it means they will die. But these people were standing in the word that Moses spoke, which was coming from Jehovah. And they say, God has delighted us. We still believe in those ways. We can see the giants, but we will enter here and take over. I don't know if you are hearing it. What are you seeing? It's a test of your faith. There are some giants in your lives. But I'm here to tell you, you need to stand on what God has promised. What God has promised, there is no giant that will stand against you. They will come to you one way, but they will run away seven ways. There's no weapon that can fashion that will stand against you. It's only to stand in what God has spoken. Whatever you are facing, any giant you are facing, it's of testing your faith. Speak like Joshua and Caleb. Let us go at once. Let us go at once and take over. I'm here to tell you, there's no delay. Let's go at once and we move forward and take over. There's no delay. Don't wait again. Shake somebody at the head. Don't wait again. Don't wait again. Let us go at once. Let us go at once and take over. I see someone taking over. I see the giants, but they will fail to stop you. I see those giants, they are laughing at you when they look at your stature. But God is above them. But God is with you. When you live here, I see God making you to take over. What are your giants? Where are your giants? I see you in front of your giants. I see you taking the plan of God upon your life, the blessing of God that God has tested you. I see you taking it. It was a test of faith. Don't be afraid. Stand up tall like David and say, hey, I see you, Goliath. You are giant, but I come in the name of Jehovah. I will put you down because today is my day to conquer. I see your giant falling. It was a test of your faith. Listen, I have to give an example by myself because I don't know any other people. I've been telling myself that it's God who brought me in Winnie Mandela. I don't know if you hear me. Whatever happened here, God is in control. Because he knows he brought me here. I don't know if you hear me. If God put you in a company, it's what God who brought you here. When you see the process, you see the opposition, you need to laugh because it's God who brought you here. We need Christians.
Ri thoka bapuluso.
Who can rise up.
Ba go phama.
And begin to.
Ba phamile.
To tell themselves.
Ba thomo ipucha.
That is God who brought me here.
Ore ba yena ya ntisitse.
This is a test of my faith. I still believe in my God. If you brought me here.
Untisitse.
No one will remove me here. No one will stop me here.
Ana mutaka nkemisha.
Can I tell you this?
Ri kilebuche.
If you reach that level, there are prayers you will never pray again. There are some prayers you will never pray again. If God brought me to
Charis,
I don't care. I don't care who says what. I reach a level of that point and say, I don't care what devil says. It's God who brought me here. Can I ask you, do you know where God brought me? You. In that company, in that business, in that family, I'm born in the family of Makananisa. It's God who brought me there. And it's God who will make me different from others. I must not associate with the curses there. Whatever happened, is a test of my faith. So I trust God. God, that he brought me here, he will open a way for me, and I will succeed where there is no way. I will find a way. I see some people here today, as you are listening to me, what you were facing, it was a test of your faith. And remember, it's God who brought you there. It's God. I see God. God lifting you.
Yeah,
I see God raising you. I see God advertising you. He brought you here so that you hear this message. The problem of the past will never work against you. They will work to promote you. The problems of the past, even what people are saying against you, it's time to laugh when you hear what they are saying. Because God has allowed what you are facing to face it. It's a test of your faith. Rise up and shake off the challenges outside and tell yourself, my God knows he brought me here and he will never allow me to die. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Let me prophesy someone who's listening to me. Whether you are born in a poor family, whether your job is difficult now, you are supposed to be a first millionaire. I'm giving you, you are going to be a first millionaire. Tell us, you are going to be a first millionaire. You are going to be a first millionaire. Because whatever you were facing, when you get money and you don't know what you have done with it, it tells you you're a millionaire. You're a millionaire in disguise. The rejection you are facing is telling you you're a celebrity. Whatever you are facing is opposite of what God wants to do with you. It's a test of your faith. I say it's a test of your faith. I see the test of your faith approved by God. And God said you have done well. Go to a next level. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's how I say, my friend.
Jesus,
how is your situation? Look at somebody's eye, you see
that
the person was going through a lot. Look at somebody's
eye.
Say, how is your situation? You'll see it's a painful thing. Let me show you the scripture. In Hebrews 5 verse 7.
Hebrews 5 verse 7.
It says, in the days of his earthly life, Jesus offered up both petitions and supplications with fervent crying.
Amen.
And tears to the one who was able to save him.
Amen.
From death, and he was heard because of his reverent submission towards God.
Amen.
That is his determination to do God's will.
Ko ikemeshetsa gae ha o dia thato ya papa.
Even Jesus.
Le Jesu.
He knew that there is nobody who can save him.
Natsi bora hayo ya ka mophulusa.
Always.
Me tai.
He went to God, tears moved.
Oya umdimo dikeledi diela.
Crying.
Allah.
Telling God petitions.
Mucha mutimo dilo tsa gae.
Can I tell you this?
Ere ke le botseng.
One of the things that Jesus was speaking.
Ntwe Jesu na bolela ka yona.
Was Father.
Ne le papa.
Don't allow anything.
O se ka dumela o robe le silo.
In me or people around
me.
Mo
bona o ba batho ba ke leng ga o swele bona.
To stop your will about.
Dilo tse wedi emise thato ya gao kana.
About me.
Kana.
Because I can be a symbol.
Kana nanga ba sika.
And end up stopping your plan.
Ka feletsa ke emise plani ela ye botsa.
I'm here to fulfill your plan.
Na ke moto phetagatsa thato ya gao.
Listen to this.
Tele jang.
I want to tell you that. I want to declare that to you. You will never die until the plan of God comes to pass in you. I'm telling you now. You must never laugh at someone's situation. Even Jesus cried,
prayed.
Asking God for his ability so that he'll be able to do God's will. Can I tell you this? Jesus could heal people, but before God was nothing. Healing people was nothing. What Jesus was there for, he had to die. So Jesus was saying, the will for you, for me to die for your people, I must not block it. Because I know when I die, people will say it's over. But what I know, there is resurrection. There are some people who are here today. They've been buried. People forgot them. Even their friends are gone. But listen to this. What you were facing, it was a test of your faith. But from today, there's a resurrection power. You will rise again. I see you rising up and be in charge. Tell someone, say, hey, I want to be in charge. Are you ready to be in charge? Who's ready to be in charge? Are you ready to be in charge? Listen, from now on, God will never allow things to happen unless it is your approval. You will approve it. You will stop it because you have passed the test. God wanted you to pass the test. Whatever you say now, it will come to pass. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Tell somebody very close to you. Do you know what I was facing? I'm sure somebody told you about it. Can you tell someone? It was my test of faith. Your test of faith is there to promote you. I'm seeing some people now here. God say I must speak with people who have been here for many years. This is the time to shine. God say I must speak with people who believe in this ministry. Whether they came here last year or... God say this is the time of overtaking. Is a time of becoming better than your enemy. I'm seeing people who are oppressed where they are working. I'm laughing at your oppressors. I'm just laughing at your oppressors. I say I'm laughing at your oppressors. They will resign.
Eh, eh, bata resign.
I said they will resign.
Kere bata resign.
I said they are resigning.
Kere bata tuela msebezi.
You won't start next year with them.
I can start next year, kabo.
I remove them.
Gabatusha.
In the name of Jesus.
Kalevisola Jesus.
I remove them.
Gabatusha we.
In the name of Jesus.
Kalevisola Jesus.
If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.